Hello, everybody. Today we're back on my Pixelmon single player, and it's about to go night. Oh, frame lag. It's about to go nighttime, so we're gonna sleep really quick. Today's episode is actually a very interesting one, and I didn't actually think this was possible until I tested it out. We're making a diamond farm. We're making a diamond farm. I really was kind of amazed. Like, ever since I made that boss farm, I've been thinking of other ways to try and do it. I could make an iron farm with magnemites and a tundra ortega. I always get those mixed up. I always do it. Stop yelling at me. Hey, Firo. Aw. My scyther's on fire. Get off fire. I don't want those feathers. Get out of here. No, I want that. Yeah, thank you. We're gonna make a diamond farm. So the way to do this is, if you guys don't know, Dratini's... Oh, that's a... Why is that? Why is there a scyther spawned over there? Did I miss some leaves? What? That can't be right. But Dratini's and Dragonairs drop diamonds, which is unbelievable. And those guys spawn in river biomes. Now, where did this guy spawn? Where? Is there like a secret little... Did he fall down from up there? Where did you come from? You should not be able to spawn. Like, that's... No. Stop that. Okay. This guy is a tricky one. He must have came from a distance. Wow. All right, I'm impressed. You know, you can live for now. But we're going to make a diamond farm. So the way to do this is basically find a river. I already chose one. I kind of already have it mapped out. I have it mapped out up in the sky. You have to do this in by the build limit too, by the way. Or you don't have to, but it's a lot more efficient. Basically the same thing with the boss farm. And that's something else I want to talk about. There was a few comments saying people can't do this, they built it and it doesn't work. It should be working. I haven't tested it out if you haven't burnt down the jungle yet. Wait, where am I going? No. But just build it up in the sky limit in a jungle biome, grass blocks and leaves. It should work, no problem. But we're going to use this river biome right here. This is going to work up there. I already have it mapped out. Let's go up. Come on, Charizard. We're going to fly up. Charizard doesn't fly up as fast as he used to. That makes me sad, even though he's actually flying up really fast. Ah, he went too far. Too far, too far, too far, too far. Down, 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 down. Ha! There you go. Thanks, buddy. Alright, so I already mapped this out. What I need to do is make some ladders so I can get up there no problem. And basically, Dratinis and Dragonairs can spawn regardless of if the water is flowing or not. So I can make them spawn in there and have them go to a specified point, kind of like the boss farm, and just kill them that way. Wait. Did I want to do it higher? I did want to do it higher. Okay. So now that we have this mapped out, let's go all the way up here. I'll show you guys how I mapped it out really quick. I'll need to go back down and grab some cobble. Ah, MLG at ladder climbing. Let's grab some of you, throw you in there. Throw you in there. We'll keep one of those. There we go. Who fell? Is that a boss? Is that a red boss? That's a Venonat. So yeah, I don't know why it wouldn't be working for other people. If you could specify like what you did. I mean, literally, it's just up at the world build limit, the around 250 Y. Grass blocks, has to be grass blocks. Don't forget that. Oak leaves. Yeah, and they'll spawn on and just walk off, and then just have the water flow into a lava stream. And put hoppers underneath it. You don't necessarily have to put hoppers in it. I'm probably going to end up getting rid of those hoppers just to use them over here because I'd rather have those over there. But yeah. Basically, I don't want seeds anymore. This is ridiculous. I don't want seeds or eggs. I don't want them. They suck. So let's go up here. And I already have it mapped down out back down here, but we're going to do it up here anyways just to give you a little show. That's the build limit, so yeah. No problem. Let's go. Okay, let's put it on F3. You can see the river biome. See, river right here. River, 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 river. We could just do this, I think. Yeah, we should be able just to do this. River, jungle, river. So we're just going to go like this all the way across. Basically, this is not only a diamond farm. This is also a lovely food farm. You get tons and tons of Magikarps, which in Pixelmon, it's damn hard to get food. It really is. They made it a lot more difficult than just survival. Basically, like, there's no cows, there's no animals. If you want to, like, kill a mill tank, there'll only be one, and he doesn't even guarantee a drop of it. So, Magikarps guarantee a drop of food. And there's a lot of them about to start spawning. So this is really, really good news. Just to be able to have this. So we'll go all the way out. See, it's jungle right now. But I'd rather have a perfect square knowing that there's a river biome in here. This may take a little bit of spawn away from the Dragonairs, but that's not a big deal. I mean, if I really wanted to go for an extremely efficient one, I'd use that river down there. Just because there's so much more room to spawn in. But it's farther away. I don't want to do that. That's more difficult. And also may not spawn as many as I would like. Just because it's too far away from this boss farm. This actually also works as a boss farm. So if you wanted to use this as a boss farm, go right ahead. It'll work too. Just I don't think it'll work as good as my other ones. There are some glitches to this one though. The fish are very weird. They are. Like they'll get stuck in blocks for no reason. I don't know if they'll get fixed or not, but usually it's just a graphical glitch. They'll fix themselves eventually and go downstream. Once the stream will take them, they'll go. It just takes a few seconds. Let's see this. Now what I want to do is replace a lot of this with glass so I could see how well it's working. Because I can't go like up high or whatever. I mean, like the highest I could go is over there, and I don't want to do that. See, I want to build a bit of this out of glass so I could go underneath it and see. I don't know if the Pokemon can actually spawn on glass. I just know that they can spawn on cobblestone because this is what I did in creative mode. So yeah, everything should work great. We'll get this done. So what I'm going to do now is stop recording for a second and fill this in and build some walls over here. Specifically, just go like 3 high, I think. Yeah, that should be good enough for me. 3 high. All the way around, and then we'll make a little killing machine area over there. So guys, I will be right back. Hold on. Alright guys, I'm back. Made more progress on this. I deleted the last bit of recording because there's a snowblower behind me. I hope to God you guys cannot hear that again. It started to snow today in Chicago, and it's the people decide to go snowblow even though there's not even an inch on the ground. I don't understand that, but you know, whatever. So this is the point where, so this was the edge of it right here. Now, what I did was I added a 3 additional things to the sides over here, over there too, and this is going to be where they collect. So there's going to be a middle part. We have to decide where the middle is. So it is across. We want 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll decide this in a second. Hold on. Let's get this glass up, and then we'll do that really quick. Did I see a boss? No, I did not. Like I said before, this is actually a lot easier to build than the boss farm. It's very straightforward and simple. Like, if this design doesn't work right here, I mean, it works fine, but if I wanted to make it a bit more efficient, like maybe I want more food or something along those lines, I could just widen it, no problem. Or I could find a bigger river to get more diamonds. It works the same. I mean, you don't really need an insane amount of diamonds in Pixelmon. I can't think of anything that would really come in handy. Maybe diamond hammers? I don't know. I mean, this also works as a boss farm, to be honest, too. But that's besides the point. You see the little wood right there? Let's see if we could get this down. Do I have a... No, I do not have a water bucket on me. Wee! There we go. I should have, like, 3 in here? 2. That works, too. Alright, so let's get this down and see where the middle is. Now, I could stop the water no problem with signs, so if I have to, that's not a big deal. Let's see. Water go down. And water go down. I made a bunch of hoppers too. There's a lot of iron. Give me this back. Give me this back. Okay. So that's the middle over there. Now I feel like there is no middle. No, they both meet up right there. That works out fine. Yeah, that'll work out fine. So now we just need to go make some signs and also bring this down a bit more. Do I want to use glass? Yeah, we'll use glass. Why not? We could use glass all the way down. No, I'm not. I don't have enough. I lied. We're using cobblestone. We're not going to be able to see it perfectly. But what this is going to do is stop them from moving. So where did I decide was the middle? These two. We'll do these 4. All right. So we'll break these guys right here. This is a silk touch shovel, in case anyone's wondering. That's why I'm breaking it with it. I don't even know if I'll get the glass back. Okay, there we go. We got 1, at least. Okay, so now I need to go... How do I do this? Let's bring this one down. I hate working on ladders. And we'll go over there. Just in case we get like an enormous dragon air or something like that that can't fit down. So we'll bring this all the way down here. I wish I had more glass, but I'm just not gonna go mine up a ton of them. It's not worth it in my opinion. Okay, let's go back up. Let's go back down, why not? So I have to bring you two, and this guy goes up. Yeah, that's about right. Okay, so down here, let's get this down. I could do this off camera, but let's get this part down. So it's four across, these four. And what I'm gonna do is put my hoppers here. I have 52, that's way more than enough. I'm just assuming in the future I'm gonna need more. So the central point, there is no center. Right. 1, 2, 3, 4. Wait. Okay, so it goes down here. I lied. It's right there. Okay, so there's no center point, so we'll just make this one be it. Alright, put one right there. And then have all the hoppers lead into that single hopper right there. So I'll go like that. Go, ah, da, 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 da. I'll go like that. Bump. 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 Shift on top of it. And there we go. Alright, that's enough of the hoppers. Now we just have to get this cobblestone up. So I'll just bring the cobblestone up here, make it so that they can't escape, and I will be right back. This is going to be another episode where there's a lot of jump cuts, just because this building thing is kind of obnoxious, to be honest. Alright, let's bring this guy down. There we go. Don't fall down. I feel like I'm going to die. I've died a lot while building these last two things. Alright guys, I'll be right back. Another thing that I need to do is, will I have enough? Oh yeah, I have enough lava. Okay, I'll be right back. And I'm back. So this is another one of those easy parts, just kind of tedious. So what you want to do is just get a full stream going, just across here. Here, like that. Perfect. So as you can see, it's not fully across here. So we're going to get to the point where it ends right here. We're just going to keep making water sources just like this. Just bump, 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 bump. Just everywhere. I think I could actually just do this, right? There we go. Yep. So just go like this until that water stream hits that last piece of cobblestone or whatever block you used. Let's see. There we go. Alright, that's good enough for me. So that'll have it so that they'll spawn anywhere around here, but once they get to this point, they will be forced to come down into here. Burn. So what I need to do now, oh god, I couldn't get out of that water stream, is make signs. And we'll put signs all down there. So let's go down here. Oh, nope, I think I have the wood on me. Yeah, I do. Those guys are dying and they're obnoxious. I don't like them one bit. Okay, so let's make that many, should be good. And then go all around. Perfect amount. See, I'm a genius. You don't even need that many. Hey, dudes. Next episode, what I'm going to do is go caving and see how many fossils we can get. Oh, you see? Look at how great this is. This is all gonna be food. Now, as you guys probably know, Dratinis and Dragonairs are very rare, so that's why this is just an AFK farm. Garp! Fucking garp! Alright, let's get this done. I wish I could make them despawn, because it's gonna get kind of obnoxious. Alright, let's see. Where do I want to put this? I want the signs to go right there. Right there. There. Just do it all around here underneath the first layer of glass or whatever block you decided to use. Ah! Okay, and now we want to go one right there. One right there. Nope, nope. None right there. It's tricky on a ladder. Let's actually... Okay, can you break? There we go. Okay, let's put one cobblestone right there and we could do this a lot easier. Okay, so now we got one there already. So we just go across here. All that is good. Go across here and then go. Are we good? Yeah, I just need to replace this with some. Actually, I can do that now. Let's actually get rid of all these ladders really quick. Ah, crap. I didn't think this one through. Alright, come here. These guys are annoying. Get out of my way. Okay. So, how I'm gonna do this is gonna be very annoying, and I wish I had an axe. Yeah, I really wish I brought an axe. Alright, let's go to down to the bottom. Screw this. We'll put the lava down. We can break you now too, right? Yeah, there should be no water that can get through. I think I got all the parts. So let's replace you. We'll trade you out for a hopper. There we go. And there should be a few things in here, right? Yeah, 3 cobblestone that's dropped down from the bottom. So now what we're going to do is put cobble all around there. We're going to leave this space open so I can get in. I can't do the lava yet, actually. I have to be able to get through. So let's make that axe and just get this over with really quick. Where is my wood? There it is. Some sticks. And make a cobblestone axe. Are there any bosses over here? No, they're not. They're just fighting. They're just duking it out. Actually, what we can do really quick while we're down here is get rid of that. And make these into pressure plates. And have 4. And put these down because the lava cannot go through pressure plates. So that's what I did over here if you guys want to take a look. Pressure plates just across here. The lava can't go through and it's very easy to see. Oh, actually, yeah, let's do that now. Trade these for glass. That's such an annoying sound, I know. Bump. There we go. So now we even get a better look through there. Perfect. I should have done that in the first place, but I never really thought of it. Okay, so now we're going to go up here and get rid of these. Can you move? Really? There, Slash. God, this is going to get obnoxious. Okay, I wish I had a command that could just get rid of all these guys. Oh. There we go. Okay. We got this. No, Goldeen, get out of the way. Get out of the way, you stupid Goldeen. Ah. Oh, whatever. We'll just leave that there. I'll grab it sooner or later. Alright, so now we'll break this, and this will just come down here, and there's nowhere for it to go. Put a sign right there. That'll keep it up. And now we can get rid of all of these guys. Where is my... There it is. Now there's still one thing left to do, and that's put the lava down, but we're going to do that once I get out of here. So I can break you. I can break you. I can break... Let's actually go from the end first. That'll be a lot easier. There we go. They should start falling once I break these glasses right here. This should trigger them, right? Oh no, he's stuck on the ladder. Okay, well, I'll get rid of the entire ladder. Don't worry. Go away, please. Garp. This is so loud. All right, let's see. Will this work? No, it will not. Okay, so they can still swim, which is not what I wanted to happen. So now we have to rearrange this entire thing. So let's break. Where's my axe? There it is. See, I'm still testing. My test world was a lot easier and a lot cleaner. Let's break you. Okay. Now ladders again. Now if you could just get out of my way, that'd be great. Okay, come on, Scyther. Kill him quick. Good job, Scyther. Okay. Oh, what the? No, 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 no. Oh, I might die. Hold on. Oh, there, they all fell down. What just happened? Why'd they all decide to fall down? This ladder should not be holding all of them up. Oh, okay, they will fall down. No, this works. This works fine, actually. Okay, let's go. Why can I not go through this block? Are all the Magikarps blocking it? Would you get out of the way? I just want to break this ladder. Ah. Get out of the way! I got it. Okay, let's go right at the corner. Okay, we're just going to leave that one there. We're going to break down all these ladders and see how well it works. Okay. It's going to take so long. Once I break this one... Oh, okay, we got to put the sign back. This is a mess. This was a lot easier in creative mode. Okay, so if I break you, I should be able to stand on them and break them a lot faster, right? Yep, okay. So why they aren't falling is kind of beyond me. They might be down at the bottom right now. They're just glitching out. We'll see what happens. Okay. So I'm going to have to kill all these guys manually and then put the lava down. Okay, get out of my way. Trust me, this is a lot easier in creative mode. Okay, so I made a mess. Alright, no big issue. Let's go ahead and bring this up now. Block you off. Look at these little golden and magic carp. I wish they started suffocating when they were out of water for too long. That'd be pretty cool. Alright, where's this mess that I made? Oh, I broke an extra few blocks. Okay. Does that fix it? Yep. So it may take a few extra seconds for them to fall down, but if you could... Ah, I feel like I should fix this. Hold on. We're fixing this. Okay. This is a complete mess right now. Just give me a second. Let's go over top. Is that a boss Goldeen? Or is that just differently colored? It's special. Okay. That's Sea King. Okay. So what we can do is this is the easy part. Block this off so I could stand on it. Okay, all of you need to go away. You know what? I'll be right back. Hold on. All right, Scyther just went ham on them. So I could finally break that thing. Happy days. So now I could put signs all across here. This will just stop the water flow from going over here. Just like that. Now I need to go across there. So let's go up one. Break this guy. They should not be able to spawn. Yeah, they're not able to spawn when I'm this close to it. So let's go across. And place this right there, this right there, and that right there. Now that water should go away. Okay, see, this is a lot easier. I don't know why I didn't do this in the first place, but I decided that that would have been a better idea. So just put these across at the end where you want them to fall down. I suggest having it 4 long, because I feel like that's how long Dragonairs and Dratinis are. Just more testing, or enormous ones are. More testing will show how big they are, and I'll tell you guys sooner or later. Let's break this now. Oh, God. Okay, I didn't do this right. Hold on. I'm not doing anything right today. This is why I don't do tutorials on my channel. This gets very obnoxious. Okay, so I can break you. Place you down. I'd suggest going into creative mode when you make this. A lot. Okay, we can break all these signs. Even though they don't make a difference, I just want them gone. They're ugly and hideous. Okay, there we go. Now, let's hope I survive. Whee! They cushioned my fall. But I am stuck. I've fallen and can't get out. Okay, kill them all. Okay, there we go, I'm out. That wasn't too bad at all. So now, I can go ahead and just burn all these bastards up. I'm so happy to kill them. Come here. Put you in the corner. Nobody puts baby in a corner. That should get all of it, right? One more block over here. Alright, let's see. Now, where I put... I have to break these guys and put... Which one do I have to break? Is it this one? Where is my hopper leading into? Is it this block? No, it's not. Okay. So, let's put back this cobblestone. You can hear... Freaking seeking burning. Now put this guy back. Break this. This is obnoxious because it's raining. Don't worry. Any other time this will be fine and won't make that noise. Okay. And now let's make get out of here. Air slash him. And air slash him. Yeah, food. And now let's grab you. Make a large chest. Bump, bump. See, this is exactly why I don't do tutorials. I'm not good at explaining myself. Alright, all good. So let's see how many things this has. There's all my glass. Oh, there's all my stuff too. That's where my wallet went. Yep. See? It's gonna keep dropping fish, and eventually, let's actually change these guys to glass, just to see. And I'll keep an eye on this dude to see how big the Dragonairs and Dratinis are. In creative mode, I didn't get enough of a chance to see how it is, but we'll go up there and watch him for a little bit. So yeah, this works great. Right now it is 1:30 p.m., and I am going to go AFK and write an essay. And in about an hour, 2:30 p.m., I'll be back and I'll show you the results of an hour. Also, I should probably... I wonder if I could see from up there. Let's go over here. Let's see how well they're spawning. There goes Magikarp. There goes Magikarp. See, that's a graphical glitch. They do that a lot, and it's really buggy. There's Goldeen. Goldeen's coming down. You can see now he's going in the stream. Bump. Bump. Goldeen dead. See, Goldeens don't drop anything, so they're just kind of useless. This is actually really funny looking, I'm not going to lie. You can see how much food we're going to get from this, too. It just determines on how many Dragonairs and Dratinis are spawning. So from here, I can see that there's none in there, so that's not a big deal. The only problem is when I'm up here, these Pokemon aren't going to be spawning. This is actually working really well, I'm not going to lie. Dun, 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 dun. Let's go see how much fish we already have. Whee! So even if this doesn't give you too many diamonds, this gives you a ton of fish. See, I'm already at almost a half stack. So let's break this too. Alright guys, so like I said before, I'll be back in an hour, show you the results. Are there any boss Pokemon? No. Cobblestone. Stop stealing my goddamn cobblestone. Alright guys, I'll be right back. Hold on. Alright guys, I'm back. Moving around in my seat. We found a level 107 Ekans, so I thought, why not start recording when we come back here. My Charizard was nearly dead because I just battled another like level 100 freaking Magikarp. Ekans. We'll go Metagross. I don't think he'll be able to hurt my Metagross. Psychic. So, I've got some pretty disappointing news. I've gotten 0 diamonds. So, this isn't much of a diamond farm, in my opinion. Oh, God. They splattered everywhere. I didn't have enough room for them all. Thunderbolt. Not bad. Wild Charge. Not bad. Alright, there we go. We got all this stuff. But, I don't think I'd consider this a diamond farm if I'm not getting any diamonds. So that's more of a food farm. That's a great food farm, I'm not gonna lie. Either way, I'm pleased. I am very pleased with the amount of food I've gotten from there. It still, I guess, would be a diamond farm, because it will get me diamonds over time. Just, it's not getting me any right now, and I'm quite curious to know why. We got a few more bosses in here, it looks like. We got at least one Arbok. Let's battle him, too. I've been AFK for about 40 minutes. It hasn't been the full hour yet, but I'm calling it right now. I don't know what to tell you guys. I'm kind of disappointed. Like, in the creative world, I stood AFK for maybe an hour. No, not even an hour, like 20 minutes. And I had 3 diamonds, which might have just been 1 Dratini, I guess. It could have just been that dropped 1 or 3 diamonds, but I don't know. That seems really surprising to me. Is there any stuck? Huh. You know, like, maybe there has been Dratinis down there. 50% of the time, they don't drop diamonds. They just don't drop anything. But that's still very surprising to me. Oh, and by the way, I found this interesting. I accidentally opened up this, and it poured out, and then it just stopped there. So if a Pokemon tries to escape, it just dies still, so I might as well just leave that there. But yeah, I'm pretty disappointed. Get out of here, Magikarp. You do get tons and tons of food. This is crazy how much food I'm getting. None in there. What is that, 8 stacks, almost 9, a lot more in here. So yeah, over 40 minutes, I've gotten tons of food, and my cat's running around right now. So I consider this a food farm. I kind of lied. I won't say that in my title that it is a diamond farm, but right now it is a food farm. Maybe next episode I'll try at a bigger river biome so that it's just the river Pokemon spawning. Maybe that'll help it. Was there another boss in there that I just saw? Or was that Arbok? That was Arbok, okay. I saw green lettering, and I was like, oh, it's another boss Pokemon. All right, let's see. Come on, kill him. Thank you. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Nothing really good. Like, the spawn rates are really good on there. Like, even for the small little size, there's tons of them spawning over 8 stacks now. I'm just amazed on why there's no diamonds. I don't know. I'm very confused. Maybe I'm just getting unlucky at this point. Probably will take a bit more testing. I think I'll come back with another update in a few hours. I'm not going to leave this area. I'm going to keep on letting this go. But I'm very, very concerned now. Because this worked fine. Like I told you, like 20 minutes I got 3 diamonds or something like that. I don't remember. But just like right now, it's nothing. It's just tons and tons of Magikarps and Goldeen. Go away! Oh, crap. Damn it! I knew that was going to happen too. All right, guys, I'll be back. It's kind of disappointing, though. It really is. I don't know why this isn't spawning any Dratinis, or at least that I've seen. This thing is still doing fantastic. This is great. This boss farm. Any bosses down there? No, there's not. But yeah, I mean, this could be considered a boss farm too in itself, but I don't like it as much. It sucks. Like, the Magikarps get stuck up there for no good reason. Goldeens get stuck up there for no good reason. Here comes a Seeking. Let's kill a Seeking. I don't know. It's weird. More testing to come. Maybe by the time next episode comes around, I'll have another one built over. Do the chunks not want to load? I think it's that way. There's like a huge river biome, right? Somewhere. Load faster, would ya? Come on now. I know Fraps is running. I think it's like right there. Right there. No, it's this way. I lied. It's right there. Yep. The huge river biome's right there. Maybe I'll try doing that, see what happens. Oh, here we go. We got another gloom. For right now, this is just a food farm, I guess. There's not much I could do about it. I don't know. Maybe I'll figure out a way to only spawn Dratinis in there. I don't think that's really possible, but maybe. Let's see what we got. Got another Everstone. Not bad. Trick Room and Flash Cannon. Could be worse. Now let's throw you in there. I'm starting to run out of space, but we do have tons of food now, so food will never be an issue again. Just maybe coal. Next episode, be prepared for me to go caving and find some fossils. Yes, I've already found one, and when I find one, that's the time that I want to go find more. So I'll be back in a little bit. Hold on. Okay, so about 5 minutes later, not even, there's a big-ass Dragonair in there. Oh, God, I'm battling someone. Okay, hi. Hello there, Mr. Bellsprout. How are you doing? So, yeah, this was kind of another fear of mine. Not only, like, would they not spawn, but they might be too big for it. Let's go take a look at them. Oh, God, this Charizard makes things a lot easier. No. Land. Now let me on the glass. Okay, so this isn't much of an issue if I'm here. But I want to figure out how big they are. Let's see. Okay, come here. Make up your mind where you're going. Okay, he made it from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think he's about 5 blocks long, which is kind of a pain in the arse. So I might need to widen this one more, maybe 2, because I don't even know if this guy's enormous or not. But anyways, let's kill him. You're about to die, sonny boy. So we might need to make this much, much bigger. I don't know. I could level 53, holy crap. Whenever I see these guys, I can just come up here and kill them, no problem. But that is not efficient enough for me. I need the most efficient stuff possible. Let's send out Gnaws of Steel. I actually evolved this guy. I did, Gnaws of Steel, my enormous old Croconaw that I had forever. I evolved him. He is huge. Look at how big he is right now. That is 3 blocks right there, about 6 blocks high. All right, Ice Fang him now. There you go, buddy old pal. He's going to gain a few levels too. Only 1. Okay, so now to see if we got the diamonds. Come on, Charizard. Oh, crap, Charizard's unable to battle. Can I survive that? You know, let's play this smart. Let's do this the right way. Let's go around here, break these blocks. So this was another thing that I tried out. Too high water. I think that's what worked too, by the way. It's not fully too high water. It's like half and half is 1 and the other part is 2. But in my practice, or my creative world, I did do only 1, so I don't know if that worked or not, but doesn't make too much of a difference. Let's go see this. Yep, there they go. See, they just spin around there for a little while. There goes Dratini! We just saw a Dratini, okay. It is a diamond farm, hooray! Right, let's go down here. Da-da-da! Let's see how many we got from that. 1. Okay, just 1. I mean, I think they drop anywhere from 0 to 4. I feel like that's about right. I don't know if that's still the way it is. But yeah. I mean, it works. That's the important thing. We got it to work. That's mucho importante. I don't speak Spanish. I speak American. All right, let's go back up here and take another peek. So maybe it is working. I got really scared there for a while. I really did. I was like, why? you know, I've been here for an hour. Why has this not gotten me any diamonds yet? So maybe they are spawning. We just saw one just swoof on by. Swoof. I don't even know where that came from. Just come on right by, kill himself. So they are spawning. We did see a Dragonair. So there is some problems with this. Of course, the Dragonair was huge, and he couldn't fit through there. Dratini should have no problem fitting through there at all. Even an enormous one shouldn't have be more than like 2 blocks wide. So I think everything is working great now. We just need to make that one wider and see if that works. Maybe 2 wider would be the safer case, but you know, maybe 3. I don't know. it's just going to be a test. So this is a diamond farm, officially a diamond farm. Look at how much fish I've gotten since the last time I've checked this out. Holy crap. Like, there was none right here. It's like a totem pole. All right, guys. There ain't what I want to do right now. Should I continue this episode? I think I'm going to stop it here. Next episode, I will show you the results of this, the full results, and how long I stood AFK to get however many diamonds and fish. I mean, food isn't even an issue anymore. I could carry around like 15 stacks of cooked fish around with me, no problem. It's nothing. I have so much. It's just how many diamonds I get from now on. That's what I want to keep track of. Any more Dratinis? I don't see any. There's a big Magikarp over there. Ah! I become the master at that. Alright guys, if you enjoyed the episode, please leave me a like. We made a fish slash diamond farm, whatever you want to call it. I think it's a lot more of a fish farm than it is a diamond farm, by the looks of this. So yeah guys, if you did enjoy, leave me a like, comment any ideas on what you might have. Last episode, holy crap, I don't think I've gotten 100 comments on a video in a very long time, or the last Pixelmon, let me rephrase that. That 100 comments within the first 24 hours, not even, absolutely blew my mind. I really did not expect that. I didn't even think people would last that long through the video. Like, for me, I like watching that stuff, like seeing what's happening through there, but I don't think I'd be able to survive listening to myself for about 58 minutes. That's a long time. So maybe if you guys want me to keep on, like, just showing up every so often with a boss or a Mew or something like that, I wouldn't mind doing that at all. It's easy to record. I go AFK a lot. Look at how many Magikarps. Yeah, so if you want me to do that again, maybe we'll do it every 10 episodes or something along those lines. I do also want to make a world download soon. I have to decide on which episode. So yeah, guys, comment telling me things. Now, go comment. Still only got 6 Master Balls only. Yeah, I've gotten more Master Balls than I have Pokeballs. I find that very strange and abnormal. Very abnormal, actually. Alright, guys, I'll see you later. Get out of here, you knuckleheads. Guys, there's a Mew burning. I'm capturing him. I am furious. I went to go make coffee. I kid you not. Just make coffee upstairs. Nothing. No big deal. We're going to capture this Mew, by the way. No big deal. Just go make coffee. I'm thirsty. I need to wake up. I want some coffee. You know, I got to go do some homework. Whatever. I come back here. I look in the box or the chest or whatever there is. I hate this game. I do. It gave me a freaking panic attack on why this isn't working, and I felt like I was lying to my viewers. Now, I come back, and there was 6 diamonds in there. I kid you not, 6 diamonds, and I came over here. I went up on top, tried looking into the fish tank, or whatever you want to call it. I actually like that name a lot, fish tank. Did I paralyze you? I don't even know if I paralyzed you. Get back out there, Electabuzz. And I look behind me, and there's a freaking Mew. Like, this is giving me a heart attack. Why is this taking so long? Like, I go away for 3 minutes, and I cannot... And I get 6 diamonds. Or 5. There was 6 in the chest. Okay, he died. I was about to get really furious if I caught him in one shot again. I'd rather him die than him... There's 8! I hate this game! I hate this game. Why is this? There's a Dragonair up there. What the hell, man? He wasn't up there 2 seconds ago. I come back down to fight that Mew when he gets a little bit injured. Just fucking... Oh, he fell down. Oh, okay, so he could fit through there. Where'd he go? No, he's still up there. I lied. He's still up there. Crap. Like, why is this doing this to me? Let's go Charizard. We're gonna go kill this son of a bitch. That was my angry noise, in case anyone's wondering. That was just... Literally, 3, 5 minutes, however long you want to say. Took that long. Okay, come here. All right, we have 8 in there now. We're gonna go kill them and see if I kill them, will the diamonds go down or what? I don't know. Like, normally when Pokemon die for me, they die in the lava, so I don't know if, like, they come down, will they actually hit that first or what? Okay, so from this, you need to make this much wider. You do. Probably around 6 or 7 wide will be good. So I'll fix that off camera. Oh, come here. I gave myself a migraine from that. Come here. Thunderwave them. So next episode, I'll for sure have this all complete and whatnot. Or, I might go record the next episode now. Just to have it, because I know I'm going to be busy during Thanksgiving. Oh, that did a decent amount to him, actually. I thought that was going to do nothing. It's not very effective. Yeah, I know. He's dragon type. Oh, my head. This game, I swear, sometimes just this game. This Goldeen's in there. So maybe you do have to have it too high. I don't know. I don't think you do, but just maybe. That's all I have to say. I don't know for sure. Let's go see how many diamonds he dropped, if any. I gotta find an easier way to get up there, too. I could just ride Charizard. I don't know why I didn't do that. This music is not fitting right now. I'm not pleased. No, we didn't get any. So maybe I can't kill him. Maybe, I always thought that if you throw something in here, let's actually... Here, come here. Let's test this out really quick. Come here. Alright, if I go like this... Boom. Okay, maybe I was wrong. So maybe it does do it. I don't know. Oh, my head. Fucking hell. Alright, guys. I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, please leave me a like. It is a diamond farm now. I'm confident that I can say that it is a diamond farm. It is. Let's go see if there's any more up there. I swear I hate this game. Ah, Jesus. Oh, God. I'm not in a good position. The Mew was just kind of there. I just came up here. I was like, do-do-do-do-do. Mew. Look behind me. There was nothing. Go back down there. Da-da-da. Start recording. Battle him. Look around. There was a Dragonair. It was amazing. All right, guys. Get out of here, you knuckleheads.